In section 1.4, we're going to talk about different angle relationships. So we're going to deal with multiple angles and how they relate to each other. So the first thing to note is that any two lines that intersect form four angles. So we can see here that we have labeled angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. All right? Certain pairs of angles have special names. So we would say that two angles are called adjacent, that's that first blank there, if and only if they are coplanar, and they have a common vertex and a common side, and have no interior points. So that seems like a lot to remember. So let's talk about this. Coplanar means they're on the same plane, right? If they have a common vertex, so all four of these angles actually have a common vertex. They all come from that point there in the middle. But they share a common side. So a common side or a common ray. So let's first of all look at angle 1 and angle 2. Angle 1 and angle 2 share this side. Okay? So adjacent means that they are side by side. So maybe some of you want to make that little note there. Side by side. So we know that angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent angles. Another pair of adjacent angles might be 2 and 3. Do you see that 2 and 3 share this side? Okay, so angle 2 and angle 3 are called adjacent angles. Another pair we could look at would be angles 3 and 4. They have a common vertex and they share this side, right? So 3 and 4 are side by side, so angle 3 and angle 4. And last but not least, we can see that angle 1 and angle 4 also share a common side. So angle 1 and angle 4 are also adjacent angles. Okay, so adjacent means side by side, and we're going to need to remember that as we move forward. Okay, so the second type of angles we're going to talk about are called vertical angles. So that's your blank there. Two angles are vertical. Please note how to spell vertical, I-C-A-L. I understand that my job is to teach you math, but it's also to make sure you're getting a well-rounded education, which includes spelling. So please make sure you're spelling these things correctly, okay? Two angles are vertical if they are non-adjacent angles formed by two intersecting lines. So the note I like to make about vertical angles are they make a big X. Vertical angles are across from each other. And I'm going to redraw our diagram from up top so I can look at these angles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so two pairs of angles that are across from each other or they make an X. Well, let's look at this. If I were to make an X, you see that angle 1 and angle 3 are across from each other and they make an X. Okay, so angle 1 and angle 3 are called vertical angles. Also, we can note that angles 2 and 4, they're across from each other, making an X as well. So angle 2 and angle 4. Vertical angles are always congruent. That's your next blank. Which means they're always the same measurement. All right, so if angle 1 was 100 degrees, that means that angle 3 would be 100 degrees. Right, and if angle 2 is 80 degrees, that means that angle 4 would be 80 degrees. Okay? The next relationship that we talk about is two angles form a linear pair if they are adjacent angles whose uncommon sides are opposite rays. In other words, the two angles make a line. So let's draw our diagram again. Okay. So we're looking for adjacent angles that make a line. So if we look at this, angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent because they share this side. But do you see that if I include angle 1 and 2 together, angle 1 and 2 together make a line. You guys see that? Okay. I like to say that it makes like a horizon, like a sunset. So the two of them together are what we call a linear pair. Angle 1 and angle 2. If we look at this another way, we could also say maybe that angle 3 and angle 4 together, they're adjacent, they're side by side, and they make a line together. So angle 3 and angle 4 are also a linear pair. Can you spot any others? What about angle 1 and 4? Okay, so angle 1 and 4 make a line together, and they make that sunset. Our drawing's getting a little messy. Angle 1 and angle 4 are a linear pair. And last but not least, we have 2 and 3. So angle 2 and angle 3. Okay, so a linear pair make a line. You see there's that root word line in linear pair. So a pair of angles that are side by side and they make a line. So one of the things to remember about a linear pair is that a linear pair always add up to 180 degrees. So that's your blank there. A linear pair always adds up to 180. Okay? So a straight line is 180 degrees. From here to here is 180. All right, next page. Adjacent angles are not necessarily linear pairs, but linear pairs are always adjacent. Let's talk about what that means. Okay, so you can have a pair of adjacent angles that do not make a line. So if we look at this, we could say that these two angles are adjacent, they're side by side, but they do not make a line. Okay, but anytime you have a linear pair, two angles that make a line, they're always going to be adjacent or side by side. All right, you are allowed to always assume these relationships to be true based on the diagram. So that means you are all, if you see two angles that look like this across from each other, you're allowed to assume that they are vertical angles, and vertical angles, we said, are congruent, okay? Likewise, if you see two angles that make a line, you're allowed to assume that they're a linear pair and they make 180 degrees, okay? So if two angles add up to be 90 degrees, they are called this word complementary. Complementary with an E means that they go together. If you're saying you're paying someone a compliment, that's complement with an I, but complement with an E means that they go together. So an example of two complementary angles might be this. Oops. That together they make 90 degrees. And remember, if we know that they're 90 degrees, we can go ahead and put that 90 degree thing there, that box. All right, two angles are supplementary. This is a vocab word. We're going to deal with supplementary for a really long time, the rest of your geometry career. Two angles are supplementary if their angle measure sum is 180. This is a vocab word, so maybe you want to make this become a vocab word. That might be something to highlight. Supplementary if their angle adds up to be 180 degrees. But a linear pair always makes 180. But the angles don't have to be a linear pair to make 180. Let me show you exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, look at these two angles. They are not touching, but together they are supplementary. Together they make 180 degrees. So you could say maybe that this angle would be 70 degrees, which means this one is 110. So together they make 180, and so they are supplementary, but they are not touching, which means they are not a linear pair. The next concept that we're going to introduce is we can say that two lines are perpendicular. Okay, perpendicular. Two lines are perpendicular if they intersect to form a right angle. The symbol for perpendicular is an upside down T, because that's what the drawing looks like when you draw perpendicular lines. So anytime you have two lines that create a right angle, the two lines are perpendicular. And if they are perpendicular, then they intersect to form four congruent right angles. Excuse me. So let's see what this looks like. Let's draw a line down and a line across. Okay, so two lines that intersect that are perpendicular. And I know that they are perpendicular when I put a right angle here. But let's think about something. We know that this angle right here and this angle down here are vertical angles. You see how they make an X? They're across from each other. We know that vertical angles are congruent. So if this one up here is 90, that means this one down here also has to be 90. Okay? Then let's talk about this. These two angles up here make 180, right? They're a linear pair. And a linear pair adds up to be 180. So if this one is 90, that means that this one over here is 90. And again, we could say if this one and this one are vertical angles, then this is 90 as well. So we have four right angles. Anytime we have two lines that intersect each other that are perpendicular, we have four right angles. All right, let's do some practice. All right, it says, identify each pair of angles as adjacent, vertical, or as a linear pair. So let's look at angle 1 and 2. Angle 1 and 2. All right, angle 1 and 2, are they across from each other? The answer is no. Are they adjacent? I would say yes, because they share that side. So I'm going to say adjacent. If they're adjacent, I have to check to see if they're a linear pair. Well, do angle 1 and angle 2 make a sunset completely, that straight line? The answer is no. So angle 1 and 2 are just adjacent. All right, angle 1 and angle 6. So angle 1 and angle 6, first of all, they are beside each other. So they share this side. So we know that they are adjacent. But now let's check to see if they make a line together. Do they make a line? If I draw my sunset, I am getting a perfect line. So these angles not only are adjacent, but they are also a linear pair. All right, let's look at angle 1 and 5. Angle 1 and angle 5. They look like they're across from each other. They don't touch, so they're not adjacent. And they do make that X. And so if they make that X, these two are vertical angles. All right, and last but not least, angle 3 and 2. Angle 3 and 2 are beside each other, so they are adjacent. But I would not say that these are a linear pair because they don't make a straight line together. All right. Number 5, 6, 7, and 8. So now we're going to look at types of angles, whether they are vertical, adjacent, obtuse, acute. So we're going to recall what we learned in lesson 1.3 to talk about this, okay? So number five says, identify two obtuse vertical angles. Obtuse means that they are larger than 90. Remember we learned that. Vertical means that they make X's. Well, this diagram might be a little hard to see, so I'm going to highlight this one and this one. Now, if you look at these top and bottom angles, they're vertical, but they don't look like they are greater than 90. So instead, let's look beside them. I could say maybe this one looks greater than 90 and this one looks greater than 90. So those angles are vertical, they make the X, and they look bigger than 90. All right, so we're going to say we're going to need to label the angles now. So remember, when we're labeling the angles, the vertex needs to go in the middle. So I could say that maybe the one on the left side, this one over here, is angle RNT. See if you can remember how to label this one on this side. That's angle SNU. Okay. The next one says, identify two acute adjacent angles. Acute adjacent angles. So angles that are beside each other that are less than 90, both of them. Well, what about this angle and this angle? They're adjacent. They share this side, and they are less than 90. So now the question is, how do I label those angles? So we could say RNV. See if you can label that other one. And if you said VNT, or remember, we can say TNV. It's the same thing. Oops, I forgot my angle symbol. You are correct. So VNT and RNV. All right, next, let's find the measure. I'm sorry, identify an angle supplementary to angle TNU. Okay, supplementary to angle TNU. Supplementary means that they make 180 degrees, remember? So let's look at angle TNU is here. An angle that's supplementary means it makes 180 degrees. Well, there's actually two ways that we could do that. We could talk about this angle over here, because these two together make 180. So that would be angle SNU. Or maybe you noticed this angle over here together makes 180 with that red angle. So that would be, so we could say, or angle RNT. So identifying these angles, supplementary angles and linear pair, just takes a lot of time, okay? All right, find the measures of two complementary angles if the difference in their measure is 18. So this is something new that you probably haven't worked on yet. Might be a little bit unfamiliar to you. Find the measures of two complementary angles. Okay, complementary is a vocab word that means they equal 90. If the difference is 18, that means if I add two angles, and we don't know the two angles, so we'll say X plus Y. If I add them, I know I have to get 90 degrees. That's what complementary means. But if I subtract them, that's difference, is 18. So now this is an Algebra 1 skill, and for those of you that may be forgetting Algebra 1 or it's been a long time, this is an elimination problem where I can add my two rows together. My y's are going to cancel. 1x plus 1x is 2x equals 108. So if I solve for x, I get 54. That means the first angle is 54. Now, how do I find the second angle? Well, you can plug x back in. So 54 plus y equals 90. So I'll subtract 54. Y equals 36. So the two angles are 54 and 36. All right, so let's finish up with a couple examples. In this problem over here on the right in the diagram, okay, we have two angles, and we need to also notice that we have this right angle here. And so we know that's a right angle because of the square, which means that if I add those two angles together, I should equal 90 degrees. So I know that this whole thing together is 90 degrees, okay? So it says find x, find the measure of angle PQS and the measure of angle SQR. So if we look at our diagram, again, we can see that those two angles add up to equal 90. So this goes back to what we learned in lesson 1.3. Little plus little equals big. So I'm going to take the two little angles, 3x plus 8x plus 2 equals 90. Okay, let's go ahead and solve this out. You have an x equals 88. Divide by 11. X is 8. Okay, so we found the first part. They asked us to find x. The next part, they asked us to find measure of angle PQS. And remember, showing your work earns you credit in my class. So if I have the measure of angle PQS, that's represented by 3x. So I'm going to take 3, multiply by 8. And I get 24 degrees. Next, it asks me to find the measure of angle SQR. Well, SQR is represented by 8x plus 2. So the measure of angle SQR equals 8x plus 2. Go ahead and plug 8 in. So the measure of angle SQR is equal to 66 degrees. Now, it's important because we're finding the measures of the angles that you put that little m there. That's really important because it's talking about the measure of the angle. Because remember, just angles by themselves don't have measures because they're geometric pieces. So that's why we have to put the measure of the angle. All right, I'm going to give you a few minutes to work on number 10, see what you can come up with, and then we'll come back together and make sure you have it right on your paper. If you need some help, you can look up here. Okay, so we know that y is 15, and it's asking us to find measure of angle RPT. So just like we did in number 9, we're going to go ahead and show our work. plug in our value for y is 15. We get 60, and 60 minus 5 is 45. Another way that you can find measure of angle TPW is you know that together they make, I'm sorry, that should be 55. You know that the two angles together make 90, so you could say 55 plus measure of angle TPW equals 90. That would work as well. Or you can plug in your Y value to TPW. Because what happens, look up here for just a minute, please. What happens if you were to have solved this wrong like I just did? Then your answer for TPW would also be wrong. Okay, so it's probably best to go back to the original and plug it into 2y plus 5. That way you're not making double mistake. So we get the measure of angle TPW to be 35 degrees. All right, it's time to do your homework. Please make sure when you're doing your homework that you are writing, you're drawing the diagrams, and that you are writing your answers. On 1.4, there's a lot of sentences. You don't have to necessarily write the sentences on 1.4 in your homework. All right, you can just draw the diagram and then work the problems out. But please make sure that you're showing all of your work. All right, good luck.